The creatures of the deep sea are about as close as you can get to aliens on our planet. But for the aliens of the deep, finding food ain't easy. And neither is staying safe from predators. Let's explore how these deep sea creatures have adapted incredible abilities for the hunt and how you can keep yourself off the menu. Amazing. Number 15. Dragons of the Deep. 3,000 feet below the surface of the ocean, light from above is almost totally absent. In these murky waters lives the black dragonfish. This creepy creature is just one member of the broader dragonfish family, each of which is terrifying in its own way, despite averaging only around 6 inches. Equipped with a whip-like tail and a mouthful of needle-like teeth, this beast is the ultimate master of stealth. The only indication of a black dragonfish's presence is its own bioluminescent barbel dangling below its chin. Unsuspecting fish are mesmerized by its flashing orb of light, which is waved back and forth. Once within distance, small fish and crustaceans are snapped up by its powerful jaws. Even bioluminescent prey can't compromise its position after it's been swallowed down, as its stomach is lined with black tissue to block out any light radiating from its dinner. Number 14. Big Gulper. The gulper eel can gulp down large amounts of food, but its name isn't entirely accurate. The eel isn't actually an eel at all, but a type of fish that grows up to 6 feet in length. Its thin body trails behind a large head with a mouth resembling a pelican beak. Thanks to its loose hinges and stretchy skin of its jaws, the beak-like mouth can open wide enough to scoop up unsuspecting prey of all sizes. It catches a lot of water in the process, which it filters back out through gills in its cheeks. The gulper eel has minimal body mass besides its head, and its whip-like tail gets very thin the longer it grows. But the tail serves a vital function. The tip contains a light-producing organ known as a photophore, which it uses to lure unsuspecting prey into that enormous, gaping mouth. Number 13. Big Red. Unlike other jellies, the thick, fleshy arms of the big red jellyfish don't sting to incapacitate prey. They grab food and squeeze it to death. This unusual jelly moves quite quickly from place to place, seizing whatever's unlucky enough to pass by in its gem-junky tentacles before digesting it. As the diameter of Big Red can be 3 feet in length, it could easily grab your arm or leg if you happen to be hanging out at depths between 2,000 to 5,000 feet. And seeing as the Big Red resembles something out of a science fiction hellscape, it certainly wouldn't be a comforting hand to hold. Number 12. Coffin Fish. Diving deeper still, at 8,000 feet underwater, lives the coffin fish. Buried in the sea floor, the coffin fish will grab any unsuspecting passersby that it thinks will fit in its mouth. The coffin fish belongs to the anglerfish family, and like other members of the species, it has a bioluminescent lure. The lure dangles in front of the coffin fish's mouth in the pitch black to attract prey, which at this depth is a rare sight indeed. Thanks to this scarcity, the fish has adapted an unusual way of conserving energy. It rarely moves, but when it does, it usually crawls on specially adapted fins. On top of this, it's been seen to inflate itself, which scientists believe is a defensive measure to make itself appear larger and more intimidating. At just a few inches long, it might not intimidate you, but it works well on similarly sized critters of the deep. Number 11. Mantis Shrimp. The peacock mantis shrimp is the Bruce Lee of crustaceans. Its clubbed front arms can move at astounding speeds, fast enough to create exploding air cavities in the water. Prey gets hit once with the tremendous force of the arms, then again by the explosion, as high-pressure water rushes to fill the gap. There are two varieties of the shrimp, spearers and smashers. Smashers approach prey, typically crabs or snails, and deliver a death blow, shattering through any hard shell. Spears have a needle-like javelin claw that can stab through prey with just as much force as a smasher. If you happen to encounter these pite-sized MMA champs, it's best to leave them alone. A punch that has 10,000 times the acceleration of gravity is enough to cleave off your finger. And it'd certainly see you coming. After all, its independently moving eyes can detect 10 times more color than ours, including ultraviolet light, giving it the edge in all aquatic combat situations. Number 10. Stargazer. When it comes to unnerving underwater appearances, the Stargazer is unmatched. Residing up to 1,300 feet deep in the waters of the Atlantic Ocean and the Mediterranean Sea, this fish's toothy grin is just one of its dangerous defenses. A fleshy appendage on its lower lip resembling a worm lures in prey while the stargazer is buried under the sea floor. And once its dinner is within reach, it strikes. If the spiny teeth aren't enough to incapacitate its meal, it uses one of the two venomous spines located above each pectoral fin. On top of all that, an organ found behind the fish's eyes produces an electric current. One final measure to finish its prey off. This is all in addition to its upward-facing mouth and eyes on top of its head. A perfect position to lunge out of the sand and eat other fish alive. Unfortunately, many divers have had painful encounters with this demonic ocean dweller, so watch where you're diving. You never know what might be watching from the sand below. Number 9. Big Mouth. The megamouth shark is an extremely rare mammoth of the deep, typically living at depths approaching 1,500 feet. Growing up to 18 feet in length, their enormous mouths often span 4 feet in diameter, large enough to swallow a child. Fortunately, they're considered to be filter feeders, so unless a particularly annoying kid ends up very lost, they're probably safe. The inside of the shark's gaping mouth is lined with bioluminescent organs that emit light to attract plankton in the dark depths. It needs this addition, as it's not a great swimmer. Its teeth are tiny, and food is incredibly rare in its habitat. Even so, I wouldn't want to be this big-mouthed prehistoric-looking paddler's dentist. Number 8. The Real Kraken. The living legends of the deep, giant squids are optimized for hunting in abyssal waters as deep as 3,800 feet. Their eyes can measure a foot in diameter, letting in the most light possible to help detect prey in the pervasive darkness. Their feeding tentacles are twice the length of their body and feature suckers outfitted with claws to rip violently at the flesh, deterring attackers and incapacitating prey. Sperm whales, known predators of giant squid, risk getting their eyes gouged by these monsters of legend and are often left scarred by these worthy adversaries. The giant squid will often sneak up to its meal and shoot out its lengthy tentacles in order to capture it. Once in its grasp, it will reel its prey into its terrifyingly sharp beak for consumption. The Humboldt squid, though smaller, is much more antagonistic and aggressive than the giant squid, and are probably even more deserving of your fear. Known as red devils, they shift their coloration to a deep red when attacking. Like giant squid, they possess fearsome tentacles and a sharp beak and aren't afraid to use them on humans. Some divers report experiencing the bite of a Humboldt's beak, while others have had their appendages grabbed by probing tentacles and scuba masks yanked off. They're cunning, so you're best to stay away from these tentacled terrors. Number 7. Chimera. As deep under the sea as 8,500 feet can be found this ghostly, stitched-together creature. Being distantly related, this spooky creature is like a shark's weird goth cousin. Its downward-facing mouth helps it to lurk in the shadows and then suck up unsuspecting prey from above. Its meal is then crushed by 3 rows of tooth plates grinding together to pulverize flesh and bone. For unwilling prey and overly keen predators alike, the chimera utilizes a sharp venomous spine above its dorsal fin, which can cause even humans a great deal of pain. For those that decide to eat it, however, the venom is lethal. While its body seems to be made up of an assortment of discarded parts, those odd seam lines are actually used to detect vibrations in the water for ultimate stealth and hunting. Some subspecies of chimera are so stealthy, they even come equipped with an additional sensory appendage that makes them look like a Halloween-themed Dr. Seuss character. Number 6. Black Swallower. At just 4 inches in length for this creature, the phrase, "eyes bigger than your belly," doesn't apply. With a belly that can stretch to the point of becoming transparent, the black swallower can consume prey as much as 10 times its weight and twice its length. Once it chomps down on dinner, the meal is pulled through rows of teeth until it reaches the stretchy stomach. There, it's either digested or, in some cases, it wriggles itself free by bursting through the thin walls. Maybe try a smaller portion next time. Number 5. Spaghetti Monster. The bizarre-looking, exquisitely named spaghetti monster is not a single creature, but a collection of organisms. Thousands of these organisms, known as zooids, clump together to form a traveling circus of tentacles and sensory organs. Each different type of zooid has a specialized job, ranging from eating to defense and reproduction. The long tentacle parts, for example, catch a small organism to eat. Oddly, if a zooid's job isn't to feed, they don't eat. Yet by working as a conjoined synergistic whole, everybody on board is able to survive. Praise to thee, O flying spaghetti monster. Number 4. Vampire Squid. Despite its intimidating name, the vampire squid is unlikely to suck your blood. Its name refers to the cloak-like webbing between their tentacles. It's not actually a squid either, but its own distinct type of cephalopod. Residing as far down as 3,000 feet, it subsists mostly on food particles falling from above, catching them using a long stringy filament. When threatened, it inverts its cape, revealing large spikes on the other side of its tentacles. If all else fails, it ejects a cloud of bioluminescent mucus, which sparkles brilliantly to daze predators while it escapes. Number 3. Philly Roe. Despite having a swimming style and body shape much like a fish, this perplexing creature is in fact a sea slug. Its unusually fish-like traits allow it to hunt in the open ocean, a long way from its sea slug brethren on the ocean floor. It sniffs out jellyfish with its Texas longhorn-like appendages and grips its meal in place using a slimy foot near its mouth. The goldfish-sized creature then slurps up its prey with surprising speed, chopping it into chunks with its scissor-like jaws. With a bioluminescent body and impressive speed, researchers suggest this sea slug may have evolved to imitate fish, and if that's the case, I'd say it wins Costume of the Year. Number 2. Bobbit Worm. These terrifying worms found lurking on the seafloor have an attack that will wriggle its way into your nightmares. The above-ground segment is only a fraction of the bobbit worm's body, which grows up to 10 feet in length. Its head features incredibly tough mandibles that snap together, grabbing and digging into prey that passes overhead before pulling them deep under the sand. The bobbit worm doesn't have eyes or a brain and only reacts if an antenna is triggered or a shadow lingers too long. Their strike is so powerful, it can split a fish in half, and they even target venomous opponents like the lionfish. In their lair, they inject toxins to finish off their prey, and these chemicals may even be potent enough to paralyze human limbs. It might not cut you in half, but you still don't want to mess with a bobbit worm. Number 1. Living Plastic Bag. Often found at depths approaching 6,000 feet, the Siphomedusa deepsteria jellyfish is one of the strangest looking creatures the deep sea has to offer. At 3 feet wide, it hangs suspended in the depths, waiting to surround prey before clenching its bell hole shut around them. It sounds and looks a little fecal, but with essentially non-existent tentacles, this jellyfish has to adapt. Stinging cells on the bell incapacitate prey, and a net-like mesh running through its bell acts as a network of interconnected canals slowly passing food along to the deepsteria's stomach. In effect, it works as a branch digestive system to distribute nutrients across itself. In these depths, the lazy drifter lifestyle is rewarded, as energy-rich food is so scarce. Would you dare to swim with any of these mysterious deep dwellers up close? Let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.